Hello everyone, how are you all? This is your educator Vijaya Manorama. Subscribe my channel Vijaya Manorama Tutorials. Today we are going to discuss transportation in organisms. It is a part of life processes chapter. So how the transportation of materials and fluids it transports in the human beings, that we are going to discuss. This is a part of chapter 6 of class 10. Okay, so positive note to start the class: never give up because great things take time. Okay, so just do your work, definitely you are going to be successful. Chalo, so today's topic is transportation in organisms. In human beings, the rapid supply of all the nutrients, oxygen, hormones to various tissues, and the immediate disposal of the waste product which it forms after the transportation, it is a very important process which takes place in the human body. So human body is a specialized, it has a specialized circulatory system. So that is only the transportation in organisms which we are going to discuss, which is divided into three different parts. Okay, so all the three parts in detail we are going to discuss. So first one is included with the circulatory medium. What is the circulatory medium? Circulatory medium is the blood, tissue fluid and lymph. Okay, next one is blood vessels. Arteries, veins and capillaries comes under blood vessels. And next one is pumping organ. What is the pumping organ? Heart is the pumping organ. So the circulatory medium, blood, tissue fluid and lymph. About blood, blood is the very important tissue, fluid tissue which is present in our body, which is found in the heart and blood vessels. Blood vessels like arteries, veins and capillaries. Tissue fluid which is found in the spaces between the cells in the organs, and lymph which found in the lymph vessels and lymphatic organs like spleen and tonsils. Okay, so human blood, it is an average, human has 5 liters of blood, and average volume, which has an average volume of 4 to 6 liters. Okay, 5.5 liters of blood is present in an average human. About 55 to 60% of the blood, which is in the form of fluid, that is called as plasma. Okay, plasma is 55 to 60% of the blood, which is called as plasma. And remaining 40 to 45% of made up of cellular elements like erythrocytes, leukocytes and platelets. So this blood always moves away from the heart through arteries and back to the heart through veins. So those are the other parts, blood vessels, which are responsible for the carrying of the blood. Okay, so your blood is a transporting fluid which carries all the vital substances to all the parts of the body, and blood is the only fluid tissue which is present in the human body. And it is the complex connective tissue in which living cells, the formed elements are suspended in the non-living fluid called as plasma. Okay, so these erythrocytes are RBCs, leukocytes are WBCs, next platelets and plasma. So blood composition, where 55% of the plasma is present and remaining 45% is cellular elements. This 55% is included with, which contains 92% of water. 92% of water. Salts are of 1 to 2%. And organic compounds are about, proteins and other organic compounds are about 7 to 8%. Okay, so this plasma only transport all the food, carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste in dissolved form. Okay, so next come to the cellular elements, which are of 45%. RBCs RBCs or red blood cells, which are also called as erythrocytes, WBCs or white blood cells, which are also called as leukocytes, and platelets. Okay, so here RBCs are very small in size. This small size only help to absorb oxygen and enables to travel. Very fine blood capillaries are very thin in structure, no? So through that only it can travel very easily. Okay, so these RBCs are produced in bone marrow, red bone marrow, so which has an average lifespan of 120 days. Bone marrow, it was produced and it, which has a RBCs lifespan is, RBCs lifespan is 120 days. Okay, so here this RBC contains the hemoglobin, which is a respiratory pigment which is consist of iron. Hemoglobin contains iron. Hema means iron, and globin is a protein which is present in the blood, which is responsible for the carrying of transportation of oxygen. Okay, so now come to the WBCs, white blood cells, which are also called as leukocytes. They are irregular in shape and they are capable of amoeboid movement. Okay, these WBCs, they destroy the foreign substances, especially bacteria, by engulfing that, and they defend the body from diseases which are responsible for the immunity, immune system. Okay, so WBCs fight against disease causing germs which destroy the damaged cells of phagocytosis. Phagocytosis is the process. Okay, so which WBCs also help in the formation of antibodies which neutralize or kill the germs that enter into our body. Next one is platelets. Okay, platelets, they found as floating in the blood, which are enucleated, means without a nucleus. Platelets don't have any nucleus. They are bound by a membrane containing few cell organelles, which is responsible for the process of clotting of the blood. And here a chemical called as thromboplastin. Okay, thromboplastin is present, which is responsible for the blood clotting. Understand? Erythrocytes, leukocytes, and platelets are called as thrombocytes. Okay. RBCs are called as erythrocytes. White blood cells are called as leukocytes. And platelets are called as thrombocytes. Okay. So white blood cells, which are included with lymphocytes, macrophages and granulocytes. Okay, so these granulocytes are also included with neutrophils, basophils and eosinophils. Okay, next come to the plasma and plasma protein. If you see, 90% of the plasma is the water. Okay, so plasma proteins, which are constitute 7 to 9% of plasma, is present. They maintain the blood pressure. Albumin, which is present, maintains osmotic pressure of the blood. Clotting proteins are present and antibodies are produced. Okay, so here what are the functions of blood then? Finally, okay, plasma protein, here serum is a fluid which is left when blood is clotting. When blood clots, the serum is the fluid which is left over. Okay, plasma proteins, which is constitute of 7 to 9% of plasma. Three types of plasma proteins are present, like albumins, globulins and fibrinogen. Albumin, which accounts of 60 to 80% plasma protein, which is made by the liver and creates colloid osmotic pressure that draws water from interstitial fluid into capillaries to maintain body volume and pressure. Globulins which carry the lipids. These globulins again three types, alpha, beta and gamma, which transport all the lipids and fat soluble vitamins. Antibodies that function in the immunity, gamma globulins are responsible. So they are the only the antibodies. Gamma globulins are only the antibodies. This fibrinogen, which is constituent of 4% of plasma protein, which is very important factor for clotting factor for the blood clotting. This converted into fibrin during the clotting process. Okay, during the blood clotting process, that is thromboplastin, which is present. So after clotting, the left over fluid is only serum, which is called as. Okay. This is about blood. So now functions of blood. What are the functions of blood? Transport of nutrients, transport of respiratory gases, transport of waste products, transport of body secretion, regulation of body temperature, defense against infection, maintenance of pH, water balance, prevention of blood loss. So one more time I am repeating, what are the functions of blood? You can just pause and copy the points. What are the functions of blood? Transportation of nutrients, respiratory gases, body secretions, waste products. Okay, next point. Regulation of body temperature. Next, defense against the infections as WBCs are present. Maintenance of pH value. As plasma proteins are amphoteric in nature, no? That's why blood only acts as a buffer, which will prevent any shift in the pH values of the blood. Okay. Next, water balance, prevention of blood loss. These are the functions of blood. Next, come to the blood vessels. If we see, blood vessels are included with arteries, veins, and capillaries. Okay, arteries, veins, and capillaries. Arteries carry blood from heart to other body parts. Okay, arteries carry oxygenated blood. Okay, blood flow is very high speed under high pressure through the arteries. It is passing. Valves are absent. Arteries are very deep seated. Okay. Next, veins. Veins, they carry blood from different parts of the body to heart. Next, it carries deoxygenated blood. Okay. In the arteries and in the veins also, except pulmonary artery, all the other arteries, they carry the oxygenated blood only. Only pulmonary artery will carry deoxygenated blood. Whereas in the veins also, pulmonary vein is the only vein which will carry oxygenated blood. Other veins will carry deoxygenated blood only. In the veins, valves are present and veins are superficial. We can observe, we can find veins in where we can find the thrombing movement of the blood. Okay. So, these valves are absent in the arteries. Valves are present in the veins only. Okay. So, here blood is the connective tissue and heart is the pumping organ, where heart will pump the blood to which carries the protein and oxygen to each and which carries oxygen to each and every cell of the body. This is about arteries and veins. Okay. Next, come to the capillaries. Capillaries are very microscopic vessels which carries the blood from arterioles to small veins. Arterioles to small veins, and they found abundantly in those tissues or organs where metabolism is very fast. Okay, so these capillaries can dilate or contract, which increase or decrease the supply of the blood to various parts of the body. So So this is about arteries, capillaries and veins. Okay. So here, as circulatory medium, about blood we have learned, tissue fluid we have learned, and lymph at the end I will discuss. About blood vessels we have discussed, arteries, veins and capillaries. And now it's very very important about heart. Okay, what is the position of the heart, shape and size? First of all, we are going to discuss, this is the internal view of the, okay, this is the internal view of the human heart. Okay, so human heart, where it is located? It is located in between the lungs, in the center of the thoracic cavity, with its lower end inclined towards left. That's why we call it as heart is at the left side, which is a hollow muscular organ, and it is somewhat conical in shape. It is about our clenched fist. If you clench your fist, the size of that clenched fist is your heart size. Okay, so this heart is enclosed in a double layered membranous sac called as pericardium. What is it called as? Pericardium. Okay, so pericardium only protect the heart from mechanical injuries. Okay, so now external structure of the heart, if you see, four chambered organ which is divided by septa, which is divided by septa. Okay, here it is, you can find it, and that septa into two halves it is separated. See here, this is the septa which is separated into two halves, lower atrium or small size auricles, and the upper small sized auricles and the lower large size ventricle. They are large, right? And atrias are at upper small. Okay, large size, they are at lower end, ventricles. Okay, so next one is internal structure of the heart. If you see, this is the internal structure, this is the schematic sectional view of the human heart, where internal view of the human heart we can find, where the heart has the main components, which are of four chambers, two auricles and two ventricles, and great blood vessels are present which carry the blood to the heart and away from it. Okay, and various aperture and valves also, here valves also present, through which the blood can pass and reach to each and every part. So these auricle and ventricles, if you see, auricles are called as receiving chambers. Auricles are called as receiving chambers, and ventricles are called as discharging chambers. Okay, auricles are called as receiving chambers. Means the auricles, they are very thin walled chambers which separate from each other with an interauricular septum. Okay, interauricular septum, it is separated. Okay, next one is ventricles, which are called as discharging chamber. They are thick walled chambers and they are separated with each other like same like that only, interventricular septum. Okay, auricles are separated with interauricular septum and ventricles are separated with interventricular septum. Okay, so the heart muscles are cardiac muscles which get supply with the two coronary arteries. They arises from the base of the aorta. Okay, so here the cardiac circle, when you keep your hand on the left side, you will find that sound. Okay, lub dub, this sound is the sound of heart. Lub sound will produce when closure of tricuspid and bicuspid valves by the contraction of ventricular muscles. Okay, lub sound you will find, and lub. Dub. Dub sound you will find when the semilunar valves and marks the end of ventricular systole. The dub sound is produced. Okay, opposite of lub sound, lub dub. Okay, so here the heartbeat or the pulse rate you can find. The rhythmic contraction of the heart is felt as a jerk in certain arteries that are superficial in position. You can touch and you can feel. Okay, the pulse rate of a person is same as the heartbeat. Okay, how the blood circulation takes place? It is of double circulation. Here the complete about human heart it is given. You can just take the screenshot and just go through. Each and every point is very very important. Okay, so blood vessels. What are the blood vessels of the heart? Superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, pulmonary artery and aorta. Okay, so what are the valves which are present? Bicuspid valve, tricuspid valve, pulmonary valve, aorta, aortic semilunar valve. Okay, four chambers are present, two auricles and two ventricles. Now the circulation of blood through the heart. Okay, so blood flows twice through the heart in each of the circuit. That's why the circulation of blood in the human heart is called as double circulation. Okay, circulation of the blood between the heart and body organs, heart and body organs except lungs. Okay, that is called as systemic circulation. First one is pulmonary circulation, where the blood is transported between the heart and the lungs. That is pulmonary circulation. Next one is carries blood between the heart and other parts of the body. That is systemic circulation. As two times the blood is circulating, that's why it is called as human heart undergoes double circulation. Understand? So what are the various steps of circulation of the blood? That you need to understand now. When all the four chambers of the heart are relaxed, the oxygenated blood from lungs enters into the left atrium. Okay, left atrium, it has entered through the pulmonary vein, it has entered. So the left atrium is relaxed while collecting the blood. Okay, now the left atrium is contracting and oxygenated blood is pushed into the expanded left ventricle. Through which wall? Bicuspid wall. Okay, so the left ventricle now the left ventricle contracts and the oxygenated blood is pumped to aorta. Okay, now the oxygenated blood is then transferred to all the parts of the body except lungs. Now the lungs it will not go. So how this is how the blood rich in oxygen is supplied to all the parts of the body. Now the deoxygenated blood from the body is carried to the right auricle and it expands. When the right auricle contracts, the right ventricle dilates and then transferring the blood to the right ventricle. Okay, now the right ventricle pumps the deoxygenated blood to the lungs for oxygenation. Okay, so this is the process where this is called as double circulation. Each organ has a major artery which supplies it with blood and most have a major veins which taking blood back to the heart. Okay, so circulatory system where blood travels twice through the heart in one complete cycle of the body, that is only called as double circulation. Okay, this is about double circulation. Very very important topic it is. So here once oxygen enters into the blood in the lungs, the separation of the right side and the left side of the heart is full of useful to keep the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood from mixing. so that separation allows a very high sufficient supply of oxygen to the body. So this is very useful in animals that have high energy needs, such as birds and mammals, which constantly use energy to maintain their body temperature. Here, if you see, like amphibians, few animals like amphibians or many reptiles, they have three chambered hearts. They tolerate some mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Whereas fishes, on the other hand, it is very very important 2 marks question generally you get. Okay, so fishes, they have two chambers of heart and blood is pumped in the gills. So oxygenated is oxygenated, then blood is pumped to the gills, is oxygenated, and then passes directly to the rest of the body. Okay, so blood undergoes only once through the heart in the fish during one cycle of the passage through the body, whereas it goes through the heart twice during each cycle in other vertebrates. That's why it is called as double circulation. If you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section. Nature description box mein my Telegram link is given, you can join with it. Okay, the force that blood exerts against the wall of the wall of a vessel is called as blood pressure. Okay, it is the pressure which exerts by the blood against the wall of the arteries. Okay, then in the veins. So the pressure of the blood inside the artery during ventricular systole, that is only systolic pressure, which is called as, how it happens, when ventricles contract, pressure of the blood inside the arteries is high. So that is called as systolic blood pressure. Okay, if a healthy young human, he can pump around 120 millimeters of 120 mm of mercury. Understand? So next one is, the normal systolic pressure is about 120 and diastolic pressure is arteries. Now the arteries are comparatively less, that's why that pressure is termed as diastolic pressure. Okay, that is 80 millimeters of mercury. Okay, healthy young man is said to have a normal human blood pressure, that is 120 by 80 mm of Hg. Okay, that instrument which tests the blood pressure is called as sphygmomanometer. Blood pressure is measured with an instrument called as sphygmomanometer. High blood pressure is used, is called as hypertension. Okay, high blood pressure is called as hypertension. It is caused due to the constriction of arterioles, which result in the increased resistance of blood flow. Increased resistance of the blood flow, which can lead to the rupture of any artery and internal bleeding, which leads to the hypertension, high blood pressure, which is called as. Okay. Here about arteries and veins, which we have discussed. So once a difference shall we discuss. Okay, if you have any doubts, let me clear here. So arteries, they carry the blood from heart to various parts of the body. Veins, they carry blood from different body parts to the heart. Okay, arteries carry oxygenated blood, veins carry deoxygenated blood. Blood flows with high speed and under high pressure in the arteries. Blood flows with very low speed and very under low pressure only. Arteries, valves are absent. Veins, valves are present. Arteries are very deep seated. Veins are superficial, which you can experience. Okay. So the capillaries which are present, they join together to form veins that convey the blood away from the organ or tissues. Okay, so this is about the human heart. So maintenance of the platelets are very very important for the functioning of all the body parts in a proper manner. So when you injured and start bleeding, naturally the loss of blood from the system has to be minimized. In addition, leakage would lead to a loss of pressure, which would reduce the efficiency of pumping system. So to avoid this, The blood has platelet cells which circulate around the body and plug these leaks by helping to clot the blood at these points of injury. That's why blood platelets are without a nucleus it is. They are very very important. Okay. So for blood clotting, blood platelets acts a very important role. Next one is lymph. Okay. So lymph, which is found in the lymph vessels and lymphatic organs. Another fluid which involved in the transportation. So through the pores present in the walls of the capillaries, some amount of plasma, protein and blood cells, they escape into the intercellular spaces in the tissues to form the tissue fluid or lymph. This lymph is a colorless fluid. Okay. It has a network of fine channels which are called as lymphatic capillaries and vessels. So these lymphatic capillaries and vessels and the lymph nodes which included in the lymphatic system. So these lymph are very very important. It is similar to plasma. So it also performs so many important functions. So this lymph is a colorless, which is lack of hemoglobin, containing only hemoglobin which contains in the erythrocytes. They are not present. Lymph is consist of plasma and leukocytes only. Flow of lymph is very very slow. Lymph mainly conveys materials from the cells and tissues into the blood. So how this path of circulation of the lymph, if you see, tissue spaces, okay, through lymphatic capillaries okay, next one is through lymph vessels. Next, subclavian veins. Okay, this is the actual order how this lymph transports. Okay, path of the circulation of lymph is from tissue spaces to lymphatic capillaries, from there to lymph vessels, from there to subclavian veins. So tonsils are the masses of lymphatic tissues only. Thymus and spleen are very important lymphatic organs of the body. So last but not the least, functions of lymph we'll discuss. Lymph carries carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste material which diffuse into the blood through the tissue fluid. Lymph carries lymphocytes and antibodies from the lymph nodes to the blood. Lymph transports the fats from the intestine to the blood. Lymph destroys the microorganisms and foreign particles in the lymph nodes. Lymph drains excess tissue fluid from the intercellular spaces. Okay, back to the blood. Here it is, it carries the plasma, protein, macromolecules also, which synthesize in the liver cells and hormones from endocrine glands of the to the blood. Okay, so this is about the lymphatic system and functions of lymph. Okay, lymph vessels are only also called as lymphatics, lymph nodes. So this lymphatic system also very very important. Lymph drains into lymphatic capillaries from the intercellular spaces, which join to form large lymph vessels that finally open into a larger vein. So this lymph carries digested and absorbed fats from intestine and drains excess fluid from extracellular spaces back into the blood. So total points were covered. If you have any doubts, pause and try to copy the thing. Video dekhte dekhte agar aap notes banaoge, to you will feel very happy and you can understand also very much clearly. Any doubts you can ask in the Telegram group. I am there to clarify your doubts. Okay. This is about transportation in organisms. How the transportation fluids, tissue fluids are carrying and nutrients, oxygen to each and every cell of the body. Okay. Hope you have understood it clearly. जितना ज़्यादा हो सके अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ शेयर करो बच्चों, वीडियो को लाइक करो, हिट द बेल आइकन फॉर ऑल द नोटिफिकेशंस, सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल विजय मनोरमा ट्यूटोरियल्स. सो बी स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी, बी स्ट्रांग एंड कॉन्फिडेंट. ऑल द बेस्ट, टेक केयर, बाय बाय, टेक केयर, ऑल द बेस्ट, थैंक यू.